You know, something I like to do is often put myself in the shoes of my opponent, to try to think like them and see things from their perspective. Now, I don't think that's something normal or something unique. Most people do that anyway. We all do it. It leads to good discussions, it leads to better understanding, and it's just good all round. Now, I recently did that with atheists. I sat back, I left my biases out, and I tried to see things from an atheist perspective, specifically in the field of God, trying to see things that debunk his existence. And I'll be honest with you, by the end of it, I couldn't honestly and objectively see one single valid case or argument against the existence of God. In other words, I don't think atheists have one argument that can disprove God. I don't think you can. That's why I'm making an open challenge to any atheist and to all atheists to come up with one argument that can disprove God. Just one that can disprove his existence. You're an atheist, I'm a theist. The main issue is the existence of God. And you have to come up with one conclusive argument that debunks God, that says he's not there, he's not here. I must say I am disappointed with the responses I've got. I was expecting a lot of responses, and I got it, but I wasn't expecting the type of responses that I got. I'll be honest, I wasn't expecting that. You see, 90% or even 95% of the responses that I got didn't even address what I asked for. Instead of bringing one conclusive argument to disprove God, most of you atheists simply evaded the question and complained and said, we don't have to disprove God, you know, the burden of proof is on you, on me, to disprove God, you know, you guys, you don't have to disprove anything. And secondly, the atheists then also asked for me to conclusively prove the existence of God, which I'm gonna do, by the way, in a future video. You see, you atheists created a straw man. I'm not saying that you guys have to disprove it and I don't have to prove it. I'm not saying that if you can disprove it, then it means I'm right. You see, you guys created so many straw mans after straw mans. All I'm asking for is one, just one conclusive argument that disproves God. That's it. Now, you see, you atheists, you do something nice. You play a little trick and you say, we don't have to disprove God, you know, we don't, we're atheists, all we believe in a negative, you know, we don't believe it's a negative, we don't have to disprove it. That is false. That is false. That's so wrong. You can't even use that, okay? First of all, you're called an atheist. What is an atheist? An atheist is a person who doesn't believe in God. You call it lack of belief. It's the same thing as belief. I don't believe there is a God. It's the same thing as saying I don't believe in a God. It's a statement of belief. So whether you want to call it a lack of belief, a belief, it's all the same thing. And all you're doing is playing semantics to try to get away from the main argument. So yes, you do have a main belief. Your main belief is God doesn't exist. That's what you go by. You're making a statement. I'm a theist. I believe God exists. You can't say I can't prove it. Yes, you can. All you have to do is prove God doesn't exist. Negative or not negative. It's not that hard. If you can't, then why do you call yourself an atheist? Don't blame me. I mean, you guys are getting annoyed with the argument. Blame yourself. Don't call yourself an atheist then. I mean, seriously, how ignorant is that? You're calling yourself an atheist, and then I ask you for an argument, and you say you don't have to bring one? Does that make any sense? Furthermore, let's stop playing games, okay? So let me get this straight. You atheists come up to theists like myself and many others saying there is no God, stop believing in God, and then when I turn around and say, okay, can you bring me the evidence that there is no God, as you're saying, as you're an atheist, can you bring it? And then you guys say, no, I don't have to? How does that work? Explain that to me. Seriously, think of the audacity. How dare any of you go up to any theist and say there is no God, and then when we ask for that evidence, you say we don't have to provide the evidence. How does that work? Don't believe in God. What's the evidence? I don't have any. So why should I stop believing in God? So answer the question. If you can't answer it, if you can't bring an argument, then stay quiet. That's what I do. When I don't know an argument, I stay quiet. But you see, you guys, you just want to argue. You can't bring any evidence for your side, and all you do is evade the subject and create straw men. I'm going to make a video soon, just so I get rid of the straw man. I'm repeating myself as well. I will make a video that proves God. Okay? I'm not trying to run away from it. But now you guys do your part and prove your position. Prove why anybody should be an atheist. Prove why I shouldn't believe in God, like many of you atheists asked me to. You know, many atheists make the claim that you can't disprove a negative. For instance, when I made a video over a year ago asking atheists to disprove God, and then I made another video saying that atheists have to disprove God, many atheists said, well, that's a fallacy because you can't disprove a negative. And that's what they basically said. Well, I'm making this video to say that no, that what you're saying is a fallacy, that you can't disprove a negative. That is false, and I'm afraid you guys just made that up. And I'm going to prove it right now, because I'm going to disprove negatives right in this video. Let's say somebody came up to you and said, prove to me that your blood is not made up of ketchup. You're telling me you're not going to be able to disprove that? If somebody came up to you and said, there's no proof whatsoever that your blood is not made out of ketchup, you telling me you won't be able to disprove that? Or let's say some random person comes up to you and says, and they bring a child with them, and this random person says, this child is yours. He's your son. And there's no proof that he's not your son, or disprove that this child is your son. You telling me you won't be able to disprove that? All you need to do is go take a DNA test, and by the end of the week, you'll know that that's not your son. And I could go on and on and on and on. But the point has been made. You can prove negatives very, very easily. In fact, we've been disproving stuff. We've been disproving things for a long time. I mean, we disproved that the Earth is at the center of the universe. We disproved that the Earth is flat. And on and on and on and on and on it goes. I mean, disproving negatives is something we've been doing for a long time. So, I'm afraid the claim that you can't disprove a negative is simply false. Simply false. You can. You can disprove a negative, and I just did it. So, that's about it. Thank you very much. Now, as promised, I'm going to conclusively prove the existence of God. And I'm not going to use complicated arguments or something so magnificent. I'm just going to use a basic, straightforward rationality and logic. It's going to be very easy to understand for everybody. Now, if you remember, a few months ago I made a video titled Three or Five Questions for All Atheists. And the first three questions I asked were as follows. Question number one, did you create what we see? Did you create the universe and all of this? Did you create creation? Are you the creator? Question number two, if you didn't create it, did creation create itself? And question number three, if it's none of those two, then who did it? Those are the three questions. Now, it seems some atheists didn't follow the simplicity of these questions, and it seems some atheists didn't follow the chain of questions. For instance, atheists say, well, about question number three, who says there has to be a who? For instance, my third question is, if none of the first two questions are a yes, then question number three, who created it? And atheists say, well, why does it have to be a who? Because, didn't you look at the first two questions? Question number one, did you create it? Are you the creator? That's a who. Are you the creator? You said no. Question number two, did creation create itself? Anything that comes under this is the what. Creation creating itself by some natural phenomena that just happened out of the blue, out of nothing, this is a what. This is, we say, what created it, and we say creation itself created it. But now, if we rule this out, if we rule question number two out, which is the what, therefore, it logically leads to a who for question number three. So when atheists say, well, why does there have to be a who? I ask, aren't you paying attention to the first two questions? Because it necessitates a who by the answers of the first two. It's very simple logic. So now, the three questions. Question number one, did you create it? You guys said no. Question number two, did creation create itself? This is the what. Most of you said no, and the rest of you said, I don't know. Basically, it's a no, because I haven't seen anybody saying creation created itself, because we know that's nonsense. But I'm still putting it forward in case someone wants to try to use that argument. Maybe it happened, who knows. But the bulk of you said no, and I don't know. So therefore, rationally and logically, there's only one more option. We've ruled the main two sources out. It's either you, or it's either the what, creation itself. But we've ruled both of those out. They're both gone now. They're out. We know they're not the cause. Therefore, by rationality and logic, there's only one more cause. One more person who can be looked to as the creator. And that, my friends, is God, by the simple sequence of these questions. Now, if you want to grasp at straws, you don't even have to call it God. You don't have to call this person God. But we do know a lot of things about this creator. We know that this creator exists outside time and space. Therefore, we know he's not limited by these things. We also know that he's extremely powerful, because you look at the universe, obviously someone powerful must have created it. And we also know he's intelligent. The creator is intelligent, because you look at the universe, it's not an unintelligent design. There's a design. Everything's working. By the sequence of these three questions, we're putting all the candidates. You see, I'm not wasting time. I'm looking at all the suspects, all the possible suspects. I've put them all in the basket, ladies and gentlemen. It's either one of you, it's either creation itself, or it's God. Now, if we rule the first two out, then there must be a third, which is God. If atheists want to refute this argument, then they have to answer the first two questions. They have to say either one of them created it, or number two, the universe, or not the universe, the creation itself created itself. But both of you, you've ruled those two out. You can go look at the answers. You've ruled those two things out. Therefore, there's a third one, and that's God. Unless you want to say there's a fourth option, and that's aliens. It's either one of these four. But the aliens, I repeat, I haven't seen any aliens coming saying we created the universe. So that's pretty much it. It's very basic sequence of questions. If you follow the rationality and the chain of these questions, you will see it comes to that logical conclusion. Unless one of you created it, and unless creation created itself. But nobody has said that. So that's pretty much it. And that's it. God exists. He's option number three, and he's a creator.
How can we know and be sure that God exists? And I'm not talking about simply believing or having faith that he does. I'm talking about how can we be positively sure that he does? How can we know? We know he exists, not just we believe he does. And I'm going to be using very simple logic, and I'd like all of you just to follow along, and then you'd see to where I'm getting at. Now, if I came up to you and I told you, or I showed you a house, I took you and I showed you a house, and I told you that that house simply formed or came on its own, would you believe me? Of course not, you wouldn't. You would know that somebody built that house or made that house, and you would know that that house was made for a purpose, specifically for people to live inside it and to take shelter, etc., etc. Now, as I said, you would know that someone built that house, that someone made that house. You would know it. You wouldn't even have to think about it. You wouldn't simply have faith or believe that somebody made that house for somebody to live in it. No, you would automatically know this. Nobody would have to tell you that. You know, you would know this on your own. Now, similarly, if I showed you a car and I told you that this car formed or came or was made on its own, you know, it just came on its own, would you believe me? You wouldn't believe me. You would know. You wouldn't believe. You wouldn't simply think, oh, maybe someone made this, you know, I'm not sure. No, you would know that somebody made that car for a specific purpose, namely to get people from one place to another. You would know that. You wouldn't simply just believe that or take that on faith. Similarly, if I showed you this pen, this nice pen, and I told you that this pen simply formed on its own, came on its own, you wouldn't believe me. Even with something like a pen, something so small like a pen, you wouldn't believe me. You would know that somebody made this pen. You would know. You wouldn't believe. You wouldn't think. You wouldn't assume. You wouldn't have faith that someone made this. No, you would know. You wouldn't have to think about it. You would automatically know that someone made this pen for the purpose of writing a book, whatever you want to write. You would know that. So you get my logic. You get where I'm going at. Now, why is it? Why is it that when we go to the universe, when we go to the universe, or when we go to life itself, human life, etc., why is it that all of a sudden we switch course? We go on a different road. We go on a totally different, separate way. Why is it now? Why now is it okay to simply believe that, hey, maybe the universe, life itself, formed on its own, yeah, and maybe indeed there is no purpose? Something like the universe, which is far more greater, far more complex, far more intricate than a pen, a house, and a car, has no purpose and simply came on its own, formed on its own, whatever, and the same with life. Why is it now okay to think like that when we would never think like that with something like a pen? Are you telling me, realistically, logically, you expect me to believe that the universe, life, has no purpose, has no real meaning, formed on its own, but you would never expect me to believe the same about this pen? You're telling me that this pen has more purpose than I do. You're telling me that this pen actually, it would be illogical, completely irrational to believe that this pen came on its own, formed on its own, whatever. You expect me to believe that that would be irrational, but you don't expect me to think it's illogical to use that same reasoning on something far more greater like the universe or life. Now, how does that make any sense? Now, if we follow the same logic and rational explanation as I've been giving in this whole video, then we would use the same logical reasoning for the pen as we would use for the universe. We would look at the universe, we would look at life, and we would look at it and we would say yes. Just like the pen, someone made the pen for a purpose, we would look at the universe and life itself at the same way. We would know that somebody made that for a purpose. We wouldn't simply believe it. I don't simply believe or have faith that God exists. No, I know. I am certain about it. It's not a question of faith. It's not a question of faith. And if you have a problem with that, if you say that that's silly, if you think that that's silly, then you have to go back to the first point. You have to go back to the first point, that according to you, the universe can come on its own with no purpose, but that would be completely illogical and irrational if we use that same logic with a pen. Now, how does that make sense? I want a logical answer. How does that make sense? I mean, for goodness sakes, if I told you that a toilet and a sink simply formed on its own for no purpose, you wouldn't believe me. For something like a toilet, even a toilet and a sink has a purpose, you would know that somebody made that. You would never in a million years believe that that toilet and sink simply came on its own with no purpose. But you expect me and other people to believe that when it comes to the universe and life, something far greater than a toilet, now all of a sudden thinking like that is okay. You want to tell me that the universe doesn't really have a purpose, life doesn't really have a purpose, but a toilet does. A toilet has more meaning and more purpose than human beings, according to that logic. Now, if that's not enough to show you how absurd this is, then nothing really will. I want you to really think about that. I can't emphasize this point enough. I want you to think about that, ladies and gentlemen. If I came to you and I told you and I showed you a toilet and I told you, hey, you know that toilet? It came on its own. It was there for no reason. If I told you that and I had a serious face, you would look at me and you would think I am insane. You would think I'm crazy. What? You'd think I'm joking. Because, of course, it's absurd to believe that a toilet would just come on its own. We would know that somebody made it. Now, why is it, if someone says the exact same thing about the universe and life, why is it now okay? Notice, you wouldn't accept it for a toilet, but you're willing to accept that for you, a human being, life? You're willing to accept that for the universe, something so complex, something so great? You're willing to accept that type of reasoning for the universe and life, but you would never use that reasoning for a toilet and a pen. So therefore, by that reasoning, a toilet and a pen has more purpose than you and the universe. Does that make any sense? Does that make any sense? And that's what you're saying. That's what's being said here. Let's not sugarcoat it. That's what's being said. So use the same logic. Use the same rationale. Just like when we look at a house, we know that someone made it. We don't need to think about it. We know. Use the same logic and rationale to the universe and yourself. By simply looking at yourself and the universe, you know someone made it. You don't have to think about it. If you were living alone and you looked around you, you wouldn't have to think about where this came from, or how did this happen, or you wouldn't even think about that this just was like that for no reason. No, you would know. You know. that somebody made that, you would know. Just like you know that someone made this pen. Now apply that logic, reasoning, to something far more greater and intricate. I think I've made my point quite clear. I think I've made my point quite very clear. So the next time someone tells you that maybe there's no purpose to life, we don't know, and that this just happened without someone there, then just tell them, do you really expect me to believe that? Because if you're saying that, then that means a toilet has more purpose than myself. Because even somebody made a toilet with a purpose, and you're telling me that no one made me for no purpose, I mean, come on. Come on! Seriously, come on. Come on. I mean, come on. If someone told you that this pen just appeared for no reason on its own, you wouldn't believe that. So why do you suddenly believe something so different to something far more greater? You know, I can't really explain that. But anyway, that's about it. Thank you very much.